Good afternoon, everyone. This is Laura DiCarlo and Career Directors International, and you're joining me for part three of Resume Writing Tips from the TORI Winning Pros. And today, our expert guest is Tiffany Hardy of Top One Resumes. Hello, Tiffany. How are you?
I'm great. Great to be here.
Excellent. We're super excited to hear what you have to say. So today, Tiffany will share the importance of intake and her approach to asking the right questions in the right ways to get a crystal clear brand to shine through. So let me just tell you a little bit about Tiffany so you can understand why what she has to say is so valuable. So Tiffany has jumped on the TORI scene with her 2017 entries, and she is already a five-time TORI winner. Dun, dun, dun. So Tiffany is a CERM, an ACRW, a CPRW, a CHIMC, and she has a Master of Arts. She is one of just 19 certified executive resume masters worldwide. She's the founder of Top One Resumes, an invited member of the Elite Blue Steps Career Advisory Team. Tiffany has offered bespoke writing services to executives from 25-plus countries. She approaches each project as a multi-certified writer, an international business insider, and a former hiring agent. Tiffany is committed to helping the career industry as a whole to develop, serving on CDI's education committee. She is also an active member of BTL, the NRWA, and the PARW. So with that, we're going to turn it over and let Tiffany do the talking.
Okay. Thanks, Laura. I'm delighted to be here. I'm absolutely thrilled to have been invited to present some of my ideas for this awesome new webinar series from the TORI winners. So, as Laura said, this was my first year presenting my work to the TORIs, and I was very excited to take home even a single nomination, let alone five wins. I believe that what led to that outcome, in part, is my intake process. And more important than my own recognition, I believe my intake process leads to resumes that have a very clear brand that not only help my clients achieve their goals, but they result in my clients being happier with my service because the writing truly resonates with them. And this leads to minor modification requests. We all know that time equals money. And heavy revisions can really get in the way of your planning capabilities. they can create a negative memory of the client. So I've developed an intake process to minimize that. My clients repeatedly tell me that they get tremendous value from the intake process alone, above and beyond their career literature. So without further ado, I'm going to take you through some of my personal tips based on what works for me for an intake process that gives fuel to powerful resumes. I hope that you can take away some ideas or at least get some food for thought on how you might be able to tweak your process to become more effective. So number one, intake starts during the discovery call. I consider the very first call with a prospective client to be the start of information intake. For me, this is an opportunity to present a few samples and to note their reactions. I use screen sharing, like join.me, and I present at least three samples that I've carefully chosen after looking through their resume and after getting information on their goals. I try to choose one resume that could be considered a bit more traditional or conservative. I try to choose one that's a bit more maybe a bit flashier with colors and graphics, and then maybe something that's a little bit in between. The purpose is to get a reaction on what they like. This means that when I present my first draft to them, I'm not barking up the wrong tree. I know what's going to be well received and what will not. So just to clarify, I do not use the style that they indicate that they like as a template. I use it merely as an inspiration to create something for them. I also don't present my samples as a choice to them or as a menu of options for them to select from. I simply try to get a sense of what they respond better to, and I take note of it. I also only show them samples that would be appropriate for their industry or geography to begin with. Ultimately, our clients have to be comfortable with the end result. I want them to be happy. I might be able to create a resume that another resume writer would like or that could win an award, but if my client's not comfortable using it, then I haven't really done my job. And furthermore, I would have wasted a lot of time because then I'd have to go through some heavy revisions, and that's just going to annoy me. So, number two, be exhaustive in your intake and combine multiple methods. My intake process is extensive. It involves an exhaustive questionnaire to understand the details of their career and to get to their personal brand. Then we have an in-depth 2-hour interview where I ask questions to clarify their answers, but I also pose a whole new set of questions that are more personal in nature. I ask questions like, what motivates you? What have you had to overcome in the course of your career? What do you want to be known for? Things like that. Now, just as a side note, I'm spending close to 4 to 5 hours before I've even begun to develop their resume. So I charge accordingly. I don't sell my service as cheap or quick and easy. And I know that that's actually the strong selling point of some resume writers. I want to be clear that I definitely believe there's a need in this industry for a quick and painless resume service, and I'm glad that some writers are providing that service. In my case, however, I explain to prospective clients that I expect a time commitment from them, and if they're looking for something that's quick and easy with no work on their part, or if price is their primary concern, I'm really not the right fit for them. So because I set expectations, I've had very little resistance from clients about the need to have to fill in a lengthy questionnaire or to have to schedule a 2-hour follow-up session in their busy schedules. In fact, I've only had one client who complained, and I refunded his money, and I paired him with a writer that was better for him because she didn't have all of those requirements. So, but going back to the multiple intake, why do I use multiple intake forms? The reason is because I believe that people communicate in different ways and that both thoughtful reactions are as powerful as on-the-fly answers. I'm very surprised at how different my clients are in person than the impression that I get from their questionnaire. Oftentimes, they answer things the way they think they're expected to on a written form, but they're a little bit freer to express themselves in person after we've built some trust in a way that's a little bit more authentic. So sometimes the opposite's true. They do better when they have time to reflect on their answers, and that's really when I get the best information. But maybe they clam up in person and they don't really know how to answer things when they're put on the spot. So I feel that getting information in multiple ways gives a broader and more accurate picture of who the client is. So for me, I would not be able to use just a questionnaire or just an interview to be able to produce the resumes that I produce. But again, we all have to find our way in this and really discover what works for each of us and what's going to work for our specific business model. In my questionnaire, I even ask for third-party comments on their performance, which I think is a great way to triangulate and really hit the nail on the head. So I've got, number one, I've got what others think about them. Number two, I've got what they think about themselves if they have time to reflect on it carefully. And then number three, how they respond if I ask them on the fly without any forethought or planning. And I believe that it's this triangulation of information that gives me what I need to create powerful resumes. Moving on to number three, spend as much time as needed to really understand the career goal. My questions about their career goals go beyond job title, geography, and industry. I want to get at what they truly want to do, what's important to them at work, what specific business challenges they are prepared and excited to take on. I want to know what type of culture they will thrive in. And I don't take I can do it all for an answer. As we all know, if you're aiming at five different targets, you're not going to hit any of them. Accepting that as an answer, that they can do it all, that they're ready for any challenge, that doesn't allow for focused, branded resumes that are going to show a perfect match for a right fit role. Number four. Get the client to synthesize their value. A big part of what we as resume writers do is to condense large amounts of information. We boil that down into a story that's cohesive, that makes sense. It's our job to look at everything and say, okay, here's what makes this individual different. Here's what's important. Here's what's not. But I also ask my clients to take part in this work. I ask them a single critical fill-in-the-blank question on my questionnaire. And this question is tremendously valuable in getting a sense of what the client feels encapsulates their value. The fill-in-the-blank I use is this. I am an expert in blank. My greatest asset is my talent for blank. The answers to this single question, this fill-in-the-blank question, serve me in a number of ways. It can help me often see the bigger picture or the major trend in my client's career. If they're in touch with their value as related to their goal, it helps me come up with branding statements that are well-received by my client and they resonate with employers. It can sometimes give me a nice little quote to use on the resume in a call-out box if the client is really good at expressing him or herself in writing. This is probably the single most important question I ask, and it was actually a tip from another resume writer who mentored me, and I'm really glad that she told me to include this because it's simply been invaluable to me. My clients often comment that this fill-in-the-blank statement was very hard for them to answer, but a very good exercise for them to do so. Number five, ask for favorite quotes. I love doing this. I started to do it because I found it was a really fun thing for them to do. It's really revealing about their values and how they think. It can also be great if you want to open on a cover letter with a quote or include something on the resume. It's good to pinpoint some quotes that they really identify with. Number six, don't assume clients understand what is meant by achievement or accomplishment. If one of the questions you ask your clients during intake is, what were your top achievements in this job? You may not be getting the best or most important information that would be most interesting to an employer. You really need to explain what you're looking for. You can do this by defining what an achievement is. On my questionnaire, I define exactly what an achievement is. I say an achievement is a way in which you generated additional revenue, saved money, saved time, improved processes, introduced new technologies, removed barriers to success, built relationships that were critical, improved working relations, etc. You have to be exhaustive in your definition. Being exhaustive can trigger recall on certain things that they did. If you just ask about achievements, they'll often focus on things that were important to their own personal career and not necessarily to their employer. And that's where we really want to get to, the value that they delivered. Number seven, get your clients to help you prioritize information. I ask my clients to rank their achievements in order of impact on the company. It doesn't mean that I necessarily put the achievements they give me in that order on the resume, but it does reveal what the clients feel was important and what was less important. You can even put a cap on achievements, forcing them to give you just their top five or six if you're finding that your clients are giving you too much information. This can really require them to focus and give you only the information that was most critical to their success. Many times my clients will list as number one or number two something that on the questionnaire doesn't seem like that big of a deal to me. Then during our discussion, I can hone in on that and get more information about why it was so important, and this always leads to really good content. Number eight, context questions can be the most revealing. One question I love to ask is, has your organization undergone any massive changes during your employment, such as restructuring, mergers and acquisitions, major culture change initiatives, transitions into new areas of business, changes to the business model, etc.? Another one I like to ask is, what was the key problem you were hired to solve? I'm surprised by how often these context questions reveal my clients' most important career stories and uncover differentiating brand attributes that I wouldn't have uncovered through any of my other questions. Number nine, get the company's overall business success story. I find that sometimes clients fail to see the relationship between their actions and their company's success. By asking questions about the company's performance from when they started and when they left, this can be very revealing both about the context and what they were supporting. So if your client is lacking in quantifiable achievements, it can be powerful to say that they facilitated or contributed to multi-million dollar growth through A, B, and C, even if their job didn't have a direct impact on top line growth. They facilitated it or they supported it through their actions. Or simply stating that they did something during a time of unprecedented growth, that can help the reader understand and give depth to the story. Let's imagine the company was in decline. Knowing that can help you uncover stories about, you know, maybe they survived through multiple layoffs, maybe they had to really stretch resources, and other success stories that wouldn't come out if you didn't have that overall picture. Number 10, let your intake be a living process. Experiment. Try new questions. If you're constantly not getting what you're aiming at in your questions, if it's always misinterpreted, rethink how you're asking. Give examples of what you want. Just as a quick example, on my questionnaire, I used to ask, what are your top five signature skills? And I was constantly getting answers about personal traits, things like integrity, ethics, and that's not really what I was going for. I was going for the hard technical skills. So I modified this, and now I have a section for signature strengths. But right after that, I ask about personal attributes to give them the opportunity to share these things that are important to them about their personal traits. And now I always get what I'm looking for in the signature skills section. So in closing, my extensive intake process gives me all of the information I need to write branded resumes that wow my clients, that result in minor modifications, and at least in 2017 won some awards. What I love about my intake process is that it allows me to really get to know my clients, build trust with them, and it gives them the opportunity to express their value to me in multiple ways. I believe that they walk away with not only a powerful resume, but a solid understanding of what makes them unique to move forward with both passion and purpose in their job search. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Tiffany. That was awesome. I heard a lot of valuable information, and I've been shoving this kind of stuff down people's throats for 2 decades now, so I love to hear a top TORI winner in 2017 be echoing all the things I believe. I hope everybody really found value in everything Tiffany had to say. One of the things I like to stress is that, you know, there's no one perfect way. We can adapt pieces we get from each person. And as she pointed out, some of her clients react better to questionnaires, some react better to the interviews, and so a hybrid approach has served her really, really well. I myself hated questionnaires because I felt like people wouldn't put down what I wanted and it would suck up my time, so I did all interviews. And I know some people who have, I don't know how they do it, but they're somehow successful doing all questionnaires. But I know that whereas I would spend a couple hours in the interview, they spend a good 30 to 45 minutes customizing their questionnaire to the client. So you're not going to find like a shortcut for time, but you are going to find that the more modalities you use or the deeper you can dig if you don't use multiple modalities, the better off you're going to be. So this is one of those webinars that I think people are going to probably listen to and rewind and listen to a couple more times, because there was questions in it to ask your clients and strategies that are really worth their weight in gold. So thank you so much, Tiffany, for taking the time to join us today and share this great information on resume writing tips to up your game and possibly put you into the TORI winning circle in the future.
My pleasure, Laura.
All right, with that, we will end, and stay tuned. We're going to have more guest experts up in these mini webinars for you here very shortly. Thanks, everybody.